Kiribati noted with appreciation the work FAO has done in the four regional initiatives, which had been progressed in the years 2016 and 2017. While we have heard about good results in countries that have been successfully implemented such initiatives, the agricultural landscapes in countries like Kiribati are indeed far behind, requiring great attention and assistance. Therefore, Kiribati is much appreciative that the first regional initiative on zero hunger continues to be programs in the biennial programs of 2018 and 2019 and beyond. As for the fourth regional initiative on developing local value chain on food and nutrition security in the Pacific Island countries, Kiribati, however, would ask for this initiative to be extended to much smaller Pacific Islands. The report, though, points out that the initiative was carried out in the Cook Islands, Samoa, and Fiji. Kiribati has many challenges in the value chain, and it is imperative to see results from such initiatives, identifying gaps to guide our national initiatives on food and nutrition security. Furthermore, such results could provide the platform for donor partners or agencies to develop programs to assist Kiribati when that's the challenges and constraints are clearly spelled out. As for the five proposed regional initiatives, as mentioned earlier, Kiribati is pleased to see that zero hunger is again on the list, as well as the Blue Growth Initiative. Climate change initiative, I'm sure no one will argue on this, as we are all impacted negatively, though to varying degree, given our different national circumstances. Be it the 3 meter elevation above sea level of our fragile atoll islands, or the status of our infrastructure. The health initiative poses a slogan of leaving no one behind. That is indeed reassuring for Kiribati, being ranked among the top 10 countries in the world with the highest NCD. There is a great deal that needs to be done to address health issues from agricultural lens in Kiribati. Last but not the least, the initiative on small island states in the Pacific. These SIDs are both vulnerable and fragile in the agriculture sector, hence requires more attention to them. With those remarks, Mr. Chair, Kiribati fully supports and encourages FAO to conduct vigorous actions to accelerate needed actions to address food and nutrition security problems in the region, particularly in countries which are far behind, such as Kiribati. Before I conclude, Kiribati wishes to thank FAO Director General and all your staff for their tireless work that has assisted Kiribati and the region as a whole. To end, allow me to close this statement, the Kiribati way, by saying that leaving no one behind is telling us to open wide our eyes, our mind, our heart and our arms to embrace each one of us in good health, peace and prosperity. Thank you.